At our September virtual UX conference, an attendee asked Dr. Jacob Nielsen what his thoughts were on low-code platforms and their role in shaping the future of UX design.
First of all, I just want to point out this is vocabulary inflation again. As I mentioned, my mini keynote before the conference, coming up with new names all the time in the UX field, it is very annoying. But the general idea about low code is that there's low or less traditional programming involved in piecing together components and creating an application. And so the goal is, hope is, I should more say, either that end users can do it themselves, or that programmers can do it, but they will have to, they can do it faster because they don't have to code as much. And those are admirable goals, but I also have to say that those, in my entire career, that idea has been talked about and been tried, and a lot of tools have been around for at least 30 years to do that. And they never tend to kind of ultimately really do the work, because people tend to want more customization than just these predefined components. Actually, I think that from a UX perspective, that's actually a different point that's actually maybe more so the issue. And that is that from our perspective, what's important in creating an application is to understand the customer's needs, to have done task analysis, to have done workflow design, interaction design, information architecture, every single screen design, and then usability studies and making sure it works for the customers and all of that. And just because you have somebody who's a so-called end user create an application, if in fact they're able to do this without being able to program, that's only half the problem, and maybe the less important half of the problem, because users are not designers. And they're not, even if they personally do the job, they don't know the best future way of doing the job, or the ways that are necessary for all of their colleagues or other people. If you're just only creating a little tool for yourself to use kind of quickly for one or two things, that's certainly one story. But if you're just really trying to make, in terms of like a real work application, then all these things I just mentioned are super important for getting something that actually achieves the larger goal of software development, which is to improve productivity in the company and making a better tool basically for these employees, for these people who are going to be using it. And that's unlikely to happen if somebody, even if they do the job themselves, piece together some components, say, okay, here's an application that solves the task or solves the problem. This understanding what problem should be solved and how it should be solved the best, those are the key issues. And then implementing it is less an issue. And then implementing it by using kind of all these predefined screens risks, of course, that the solution is also in that sense possibly suboptimal. So in many ways, I have a little bit of a negative opinion, unfortunately. But that said, I think we should just be fair and say there are certainly also positive aspects as well. So to the extent that we can make implementation easier and faster and cheaper, well, that means that we can have more implementation, right? And we can also, for a given set of budget, if only this much needs to be spent in implementation because that's now quick and cheap, right? Well, this much is available for user experience analysis and better design and trying out multiple designs, because we can implement multiple designs cheaply, supposedly, now. So in that sense, that could actually lead to better user experience of the ultimate product if we think about it in that way of saying we reduce the implementation side of design and implementation. But the point is, product development is design and implementation. And you're not going to get away with the design. You have to do the design. And of course, we are really going to argue that the design has an immense impact, if not maybe even the most impact, on the productivity and various other positive things we want to achieve. They derive from having done all the UX work and all our methods well and thoroughly. And let's hope we can have more budget for it if low code really takes more off and turns out to work well in reducing the implementation cost of that total budget picture.